Hey guys, what's up? This is Millie here. So for today's video, I thought I would do the Wanderlust travel tag. Considering my channel is a travel channel amongst other videos, I thought this would be a good tag to do. For those who don't know what this is, it is basically me answering a few questions related to travel. I will try keeping this video short and sweet, but if it does become a tad long, I apologize in advance. So, let's go. What is your most treasured passport stamp? This is going to be a hard one. Actually, I think all the questions in this will be hard for me to answer, but I would probably have to say Muscat, which is a city in the Middle East in a place called Oman. I grew up there and I went back in 2007. But considering my passport has been renewed since then, I would probably say USA. I went there last year, as you may have noticed from my channel. And if you haven't, well, there are videos from USA on my channel, so check them out. I went there last year and it had been such a big dream to, you know, go and visit the newfound land. Can you recite your passport number from memory? No, I can't, regardless of the total number of, you know, those arrival forms that I filled in and departure forms that I filled in. No, I cannot actually recite the number. If you do decide to do this tag and you choose to answer this question, please do not give out your passport number on camera. Preferred mode of travel: airplanes, trains, or automobiles? I would probably say planes, because that is the fastest way to travel. So it gives you a bit more time in the city that you're visiting. Also, I can rake up on those air miles then. Top three travel items. My top three travel items would be my phone and charger. Well, I have a smartphone, but in general, I would say phone and charger. That way, in case of an emergency, you know, you've got your phone and a contacts book in case you need to contact someone. And I guess if you have a smartphone, you can use it as a GPS, you can, you know, check in at your hotel and whatnot, and whatever reason you have access to the internet in case you need to transfer money from your banks. Apart from that, the other two items would be my laptop and my camera, because chances are I will be vlogging around the city and I need my laptop to store the footage. Just a disclaimer that these are not necessarily three things I would suggest that you carry as well, but it's definitely three things I would definitely have with me on travels. But if there's particular advice that you want, just feel free to leave them in the comments below and I will answer them for you. A hostel or a hotel? Depends whom I'm traveling with. But I will still be inclined towards a hotel. It doesn't have to be a fancy hotel, but it's just I prefer a hotel over a hostel for some reason. So my pick would be a hotel. Are you a repeat visitor or do you visit new places? Both. There are places that I've been to more than once, like Hong Kong, Bangkok, Singapore, India, obviously, Muscat, and a couple of others, Australia, well, Gold Coast, and a couple, yeah, I think that's about it. And there are also places that I've, you know, just visited once as a new city. So yeah. Do you read up on your destination, such as culture, safety, whatever else, or do you just wing it? I don't necessarily read up, but I do a bit of research, because sometimes I travel to places that can have that where certain things might not be acceptable, you know, like the Middle East. So I just want to be aware of that and not be offensive to the people living in that country or in that city. Out of all the places that you've visited, where do you want to go back? I've been wanting to go back on a Europe trip for a while now. And I'm actually thinking of maybe doing a Contiki tour. The one thing that I'm kind of scared of is, you know, traveling alone or traveling with people I don't know. So if I did a Contiki tour, I'd potentially be facing my fears. And I'd also get to see Europe again. And I absolutely love London. What place do you want to go to out of the places you haven't been to? That's a long list. Let's see, Italy, Spain, Greece, hence the Europe trip. Apart from Europe, maybe Bora Bora, Hawaii, Tahiti, heaps more. There's so many places I still have to venture out to. What's your best I'm lost story? The best I'm lost story would have to be when we went on a Europe trip as a family, and we were in Paris, and we had set out to find the Eiffel Tower. And being the great map reader that my brother is, for some odd reason, we got out of the subway and we took the back route instead of the front route. So when we'd walked the necessary number of steps or whatever, and you know, the Eiffel Tower should have been right there, we were just staring at some random building. And we were literally frantically figuring out where we were, and me being the genius that I am, all I did was turn around and be like, well, it's right there. So that's probably got to be the best I'm lost story that I've got. You're leaving tomorrow and money is no option. Where are you going? I'm going on a round the world trip. I'm not necessarily going to do it within, what was it? Around the world in 80 days? I'm not going to do it in 80 days? I'm going to take my time, but I'm going on a round the world trip, considering those things are actually possible these days. So that's it for my Wanderlust travel tag. If you enjoyed this video, please click on that thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel. I make videos every Monday and Wednesday. If you happen to do this tag, please let me know. I'd love to check it out. And my social media links are in the description below, and I will see you next time.